Hello everybody, this is going to be a two-topic video. First of all, what I have here is, finally, I got my hands on a Type 99 Naval Training Rifle. And yes, it's a Type 99, even though it's chambered for 6.5, it's to resemble the Type 99 Long Variant Rifle, not the short. Because if anyone's familiar, Type 38s don't have, this is a Type 99 feature. Type 99 gas port. Let's see if I can zoom up. It does have an anchor mum on it. There we go. Cast iron receiver, 5-round magazine, and I have shot this with blanks. See, these are all empty shells that I fired out of it. So yes, you can shoot them. I know people are scared to death of them. And there's your 6.5 blank. This one hasn't been fired. Here is a 7.7 millimeter blank. To prove, I'm going to try to put one in the chamber and I'm going to show you that it will not fit. See? I can't close the bolt. I can't go any further than what you see right here. But here's 6.5. See? You can chamber it. Loads just like your typical combat rifle. The ejector works. These are hard to come by. That's why I'm showing this video, because I've never seen the Naval Training Rifle on YouTube. I'm sure there's people who do collect these, because these are rare, even though it is a training variant. The bolt matches, the firing pin doesn't. It's been replaced by the previous owner, or who knows. If the camera will pick up, just bear with me. God damn it. It's the lighting. It's got a, I know the camera ain't, just bear with me. It's got a sideways S mark. And then it says 6.4, and you know. And your typical naval training rifles, or the naval special, which I got two videos on that, usually all have, let's see. It's got an anchor proof mark. It's there. The, if I'm saying it right, I'm not no expert when it comes to pronouncing names. The Yokosuka Navy Arsenal. But the Navy Specials had this kind of mark too. And then on the Navy Specials, which if you've seen my video, we'll have that upside down Y looking symbol with a circle. If you know what I'm talking about. And this is a dead giveaway, that when you see something like this, that it's not a naval special, because some people get them mixed up, is the dust cover. Your naval specials were wider, where the barrel was extended out into the receiver, and the locking lugs on this would lock into your barrel, making it capable of firing, you know, a full powered load. This is a blank shooting only gun. You can't shoot live rounds out of this, because if you do so, you're gonna blow it up, destroy a piece of history, and either kill yourself or severely injure yourself. Now, I've seen these when they got the dust cover on them, And of course, it's got the cleaning rod, which it's like a fake cleaning rod. It's just a little tack nail, basically. I've seen them go for $800. Me personally, I would not pay that. I did get this one for four and a quarter, which, you know, 425, which. And it's got writing on the stock. And if those who can't read, I'll tell you exactly what it says. This is your training indicator. Here, right here, it says firing of ball ammunition is prohibited. That's exactly what it says, meaning blanks. But see, when U.S. troops wanting to bring home a war trophy, they brought these home and they weren't aware of what they had, and they were trying to put live rounds in them and blow the damn things up in their faces. And that's where the whole rumor got started about these guns being unsafe. It's because of these training rifles. And this one, it's pretty, like I said, it's beat up. But it is a fully functional training rifle. But yeah, this stock has seen better days. I put a little bit of oil on it to, because when I got this, it was dried up. It was almost, I wanted to say, dry rotted. And I did a little mild repair here. That's got a crack around the wrist. Nothing serious, but I knew I needed to fix, put a patch on that just in case, because when I buy these, I want them to actually work. I want them to be functional, even though, yes, I'm not, you know, this ain't a shooter. But just to demonstrate what the training rifle, how it works. And it'll fire. Anyways, I'm gonna try to make this video quick. The other topic that I wanted to talk about is this whole Biden administration and that Michael Bloomberg guy who's right now going around threatening other YouTubers. Like, if you're familiar with Military Arms Channel, he's a really good YouTuber on guns, antique guns to modern guns. You got Iraq Veteran 88. He's really good. If you haven't, you know, if you're watching this, and surely you know who I'm talking about. And then there's a guy, I don't watch his channel, but I've heard of him. AR-15 something. Michael Bloomberg had his team send them personal emails, and companies who support, you know, the Military Arms Channel and Iraq Veteran. And if you don't believe me, you can look this information up for your own self. They're trying to say that the whole panic buying of guns and people raging and causing violence and doing the riots that's going on and stuff is all because of Iraq Veteran military, for talking about them wanting to ban, you know, the gun confiscation, that they're blowing it way out of proportion. But here's the thing, they're not. It's the truth. The truth is out there. If you went and got on Joe Biden's website about his gun control agenda plan, read it. It said they're not making the stuff up. I mean, yes, they are targeting at, they're not saying, they're not targeting these guns, no. But they'll be next. But they're, you know, of course, everyone knows they're after not just the AR-15, they're after any military gun that's semi-automatic and usually has more than, you know, a 10-round magazine, like 25, 30-round magazines. They're trying to ban all that. And then they're doing a buybacks program. I'm sure some of you are already aware of this. Well, people ain't going to give them up. Biden's running his mouth trying to say that he's going to defeat the NRA. Well, we'll just have to see. You know, money talks and bullshit walks, so, and they got the money, so they might be able to buy some people out. I don't know. I hope people don't. Another YouTuber that I watched that was talking about the same subject that I'm talking about said he's not going to sell out, and he got a email threat from Michael Bloomberg about wanting it, trying to get, you know, sell out information about who's these conspiracy theorists, which they claim that Iraq Veteran is one of them, and Tim from Military Arms Channel. And they're not. They just are people like me, myself, and other people, gun owners, who enjoy the history, like to shoot, and even though this ain't the perfect example, but this is more of a display gun. This is something you go take out your live action Arisaka rifles and bring this along and show them about the training rifle, because people are like, you know, people are scared, usually terrified of these because, oh, they'll blow up. Yeah, if you put a live round, but I promise you, you're typically safe with this. I mean, if the thing was going to blow up, it would have already blown up in my face. And these are a full load of blanks, even though they still don't put out the pressure and the same force as a full powered round does. But these are loud enough to where you need hearing protection when you do shoot one of these blanks. And then, here, I'll put two of these together. I'm kind of getting off topic again. But you might not be able to tell. But the 7.7 is fairly larger, and these are the short blanks. That's right now on their website, that's all they got. They don't have the full length long blanks like the 6.5. But these are a lot louder, but these are still pretty loud, enough louder than an AR or, you know, a 22. But anyways, here's the thing, though. When they go and say this bill does get passed and they do the buybacks program of buying people's ARs back, even though they're not going to get what they paid for them, they're going to get like a couple $100 a piece, which is a ripoff. Anyone's a damn idiot to do so. Or you have to register them through, like you do with a Class 3 weapon. You have to pay the $200 or $350 tax stamp to legally own something that you already legally own. And if you don't, then you're a criminal. You're a terrorist. And then they're just going to take the guns from you regardless. But once they see that people are still out killing people and shooting, there's still going to be mass shootings regardless they take away those guns or not, then they're going to come for these. Even though this is a blank, but you could still load a blank up, put the barrel at the end of somebody's head and pull the trigger and it would still kill them. So that'll be next. But here's the thing, are they going to confiscate hammers or a baseball bat or a kitchen knife or a fork? Because you can harm people with those too. And I'm saying it, and we all know, because I personally voted, I know a lot of people, we all know that the election was a fraud. And let's see if YouTube takes my video down, because they've been taking down a lot of videos of people who are speaking out about this. You know, I am in this for the history, and I'm sure a lot of other people are. It's a thing of art is the way I see it. I don't see this as a weapon, even though, yes, generally, typically it is. But I'm not in it for that. I'm not one of those big shooters. I mean, I like to shoot them every now and then, but honestly, that's why I own 7.7mm blanks, because it's cheaper than the live rounds, and you still get the boom, and you still get the fun. Just, you don't have to worry about accuracy, because you're not shooting anything. But it's fun. I'm more in it for the history than I am the fact that it's a firearm. And then people who own these, you know, I feel bad winning, but these ain't at stake yet, but it's going to be if things continue the way they are. And I hope to God, and I pray, and I hope all of you all too pray, and just pray that they pass that bill out when they try to ban the whole AR-15s and the magazine bans, because it, no matter what, there's still going to be violence. What they need to do is to crack down on the criminals. Like, instead of giving them slap on the wrist for murder, oh yeah, just 25 years, you know, you double their sentence. You know, put it where people know if they do these things, they're in deep shit. There ain't no more, oh, well, if you got a little bit of money, you can buy your way out of it. No, you did the crime, you're going to do the time. You know, every day I go to work, I see people not using turn signals. I myself have been almost hit several times by other cars because they don't know how to use a turn signal. So, okay, they're in the regular traffic lane. I'm going to cross the street over here. And guess what? They turn, and I almost get hit. Well, it's their fault. It ain't my fault. I was doing the right. They're the ones wrong by not signaling that they were going to turn. And it happens all the time. And they don't do nothing about that. Next, they're going to, you know, instead, oh, we're going to take your driver's license, or not driver's license away. Next, what are they going to do? Ban cars? Call them assault cars? I know I'm probably talking stupid, but it gets to me. This whole COVID, everything that's been going on, and it's continuing going on, is just driving me fucking nuts. And so is a lot of other people. You know, enough is enough. You know, I'm going to say right now, even though I own this, to some people and to most of you, yeah, this is probably junk. But I like it. I honor it, knowing where it comes from. And I'm not going to hand them over without a fight, even if it causes my own life. They come at my door. I'm not out to hurt nobody. I just like it for the history. They come knocking on my door. I'm going to defend what I have. Whether, well, it's the law now or not, I'm not giving them up. And I'm not going to, okay, you can have this for $150, $200. No, you're going to give me what I paid for it, or otherwise you ain't getting it. Hang on a second. And then here's your typical 99. It's got the monopod. I already did a video a while back when I first installed this because it cost me a $250 for an original, not a reproduction. I saw another one a while back on eBay going for $250. No one was bidding on it. I was probably an idiot for paying that, but I wanted it to complete the rifle because everything here was all here except for the monopod. And of course, it's got its muzzle cap. This is a reproduction. It's not an authentic one. See, let's put it on. It's got the full length cleaning rod, chrome line bore. Only downside is the mum has been molested. I mean, it's there if the camera would pick up. You can see the mum. You can see the whole ridge, but the beauty of it is gone. And this one's, it's nice. And this is an all matching number. That's the beauty of this. And you've already seen the Naval Special, so there's no point in getting it out. But this whole video was, I finally got one of these. I've been wanting a Navy trainer for a while because these are very rare. Out of all your training rifles, there's like the Hiwashiki one that I showed you in an older video. The Type 38 one, those are somewhat rare too, but they're out there. And then, like I said, these are out there too, but I guess most people are hoarding them because you don't see them for sale very long. I got this one, of course, off Gun Broker. And some people require FFL, others don't. So this one came right to my doorstep. I didn't have to go through any of that because you can't shoot live rounds. I mean, you can, it's dangerous, but more than likely it's going to blow up. But yeah, the one I was looking at, the stock was more beautiful, like this one on the Type 99, and it went for $800. I was like, whoa. But I will tell you, because I bought in parts just to to experiment with, if you say break your firing pin, or you bought it and it came with a broken one, and the springs are different. The springs are not the same as in your combat, whether if it's a Type 99 or 38. The springs on these are a little bit shorter. Now, you can put a combat spring in it and it will work, but it'll click a lot harder, way more force, which might not be good for the primer, or it might pierce through the primer, so you got to watch out for that. These were all hand fitted, so you can say the bolt's messed up and you want a bolt replacement, because sometimes you can find trainer bolts. Here, let me take this apart while I'm talking so maybe some of you all can understand. And it's just like your typical Mauser. This is identical to a Type 38 bolt. The only difference is, let's move this extractor. It doesn't have the gas ports, you know, like your combat one does. Other than that, the bolt's the same, identical. But the firing pin is, they're hand fitted. So if you're trying to find another firing pin, it's a gamble. Like, I've went through like 4 or 5 different training rifle firing pins. None of them worked. None of them. So if you're trying to restore one of these, you're gonna either take it to a gunsmith and have them file it down and shape it to where it'll fit in the inside, because that's the thing, it's the way the bolt in the inside, it's designed just for that particular, you know, number matching firing pin. So, and this one's a mismatch, so whoever owned this before me either got lucky or they went through a bunch of dozen firing pins to get it to work. And originally these did fire. I have a video on it too. The wooden bullet blanks, but not all of them just shot wooden blanks. Some of them had so I'm trying to explain it, had the, well, they were shorter. Let me see, like, kind of, I know this is 7.7, so just bear with me. The shorter ones that had a cap, either just a little metal steel cap that it shot, or it had a little round ball, like a lead ball, that fitted on the end of the, you know, the shell casing, and it fired. Because really think about it, why would they have sights on them that are adjustable if they were just shooting blanks? So these did fire, and maybe they didn't have the range like others. So, and that would explain why, like, on battlefields, because I've read stories, there were people who, well, Okinawa was one, where they picked up came across, then it was documented and reported it was a training rifle that one of the, it wasn't the actual army, it was like a civilian. The ones that were hiding in the caves had one, and I guess they were shooting at the soldiers or whatever with one of these. So whatever the original ammo or the training ammo was, somewhat effective to a certain degree. Let me put the dust cover back on, and then I'm gonna wrap this video up, because it's probably gonna take 3 or 4 hours, maybe longer, to upload, and I'll probably just go to bed or sleep while it does it. Oh, putting these back to dust covers on, especially on the trainer, it's a little bit tighter. Kind of a pain in the ass. But yeah, hopefully y'all, I know the past couple other videos were a little weird or oddball, but one was, well, a couple of them I did for Japanese viewers, because I get some of them too. But if you like this kind of stuff, most of the stuff like this that I post, or I share information, or if you're looking to buy stuff like this, you can follow me on Twitter. I have a Twitter account, and I post this stuff, this kind of stuff, whether my personal stuff, or I'll share information too, like the whereabouts, where to buy one if you're looking for a good deal or whatever. And of course, my Twitter page is exactly same as YouTube, Rachel Lynn Summers. So my profile picture is different, but I'm easy to find. I did have Facebook. I took it down once I started seeing that a lot of people were getting Facebook jail or suspended or banned for talking about Donald Trump, and it wasn't hateful. They were talking about the whole fraud thing, and Facebook was silencing them and silencing a lot of gun people. And see, they were censoring my content on there anyways, when I was sharing stuff like this from Gun Broker and for good deals and sharing it to buy. And well, here's the thing, you have to go through federal, well, if it's a combat rifle, to own. So there's nothing illegal, and Facebook was censoring out. They didn't take it down, they just blackened the picture so you couldn't see what you were looking at. So I got tired of it, so I deleted Facebook. But I have Twitter. I'm going to make a Parler account if Parler comes back up, hopefully. I heard Amazon took them down, but I don't know if that's entirely true, and plus I didn't dig around enough. So, y'all have a good one, and keep up with the Second Amendment. And, you know, other than that, I wouldn't care about Joe Biden. You know, I don't hate him, but I am against him because of the fact that he wants to disarm Americans. Him and that Carmella girl, too. And I don't support that. So, in my ways, I voted for Trump. The election got stolen, so he's not my president. He might be yours, but he's definitely not my president. Have a good day.